Father Harris and I are excited that you join us for Mass during the weekends, and also now available every Tuesday and every Friday, live from St. Thomas More in Boynton Beach. May God bless you. And now the Holy Mass.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
From beneath this canopy, as you can see, we're on our way to Jerusalem, and we have to prepare for the baby. And this will be a manger above us. So the animals are on the way, the hay, shepherds are watching, Mary and Joseph are on the road, Today we'll offer the sacrifice of the Mass for the deceased members of the Gautier family, as requested by Jacques and Yvette René. I confess, Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask that Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Behold, the Lord will come, and all his holy ones with him. And on that day, there will be a great light. God, who through your only begotten Son have made us a new creation, look kindly, we pray, on the handiwork of your mercy. And at this, your Son's coming, cleanse us from every stain of the old way of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Jacob called his sons and said to them, "Assemble and listen, sons of Jacob. Listen to Israel, your father. You, Judah, shall your brothers praise, your hand on the neck of your enemies. The sons of your father shall bow down to you. Judah, like a lion's whelp, you have grown up on prey, my son. He crouches like a lion recumbent, the king of beasts. Who would dare rouse him? The scepter shall not never depart from Judah, or the mace from between his legs, while tribute is brought to him, and he receives the people's homage." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm, "Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever."
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
O God, with your judgment endow the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice, and your afflicted ones with judgment.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
The mountains shall yield peace for the people, and the hills justice. He shall defend the afflicted among the people, save the children of the poor.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
Justice shall flower in his days, and profound peace till the moon be no more. May he rule from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
May his name be blessed forever. As long as the sun, his name shall remain. In him shall all the tribes of the earth be blessed. All the nations shall proclaim his happiness.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia,
alleluia.
O wisdom of the God Most High, guiding creation with power and love, come and teach us the path of knowledge.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
The book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Abraham became the father of Isaac, Isaac the father of Jacob,
Jacob, the father of Judah and his brothers, about whom we just heard. Judah became the father of Perez and Zerah, who was the mother of Tamar. Perez became the father of Hezron. Hezron, the father of Ram. Ram, the father of Abinadab. Amminadab became the father of Nahshon. Nahshon, the father of Salmon. Salmon, the father of Boaz, whose mother was Rahab. Boaz became the father of Obed, whose mother was Ruth. Obed became the father of Jesse. Jesse was the father of King David. David became the father of Solomon, whose mother had been the wife of Uriah the Hittite. Solomon became the father of Rehoboam. Rehoboam the father of Abijah, and Abijah the father of Asaph. Asaph became the father of Jehoshaphat, and Jehoshaphat the father of Joram. Joram was the father of Ahaz, and Ahaz the father of Hezekiah. Hezekiah became the father of Manasseh, and Manasseh the father of Amos. Amos the father of Josiah. Josiah became the father of Jeconiah and his brothers at the time of the Babylonian exile. After the exile, Jeconiah became the father of Shealtiel. And Shealtiel, the father of Zerubbabel. Zerubbabel, the father of Abiud. Abiud, the father of Eliakim. Eliakim became the father of Azor, and Azor, the father of Zadok, the priest. Zadok became the father of Achim, and Achim, the father of Eliud. Eliud, the father of Eleazar. Eleazar became the father of Matan, and Matan, the father of Jacob. Jacob, the father of Joseph, the husband of Mary. Of her was born Jesus, who is called the Christ. Thus, the total number of generations from Abraham to David is 14 generations. And from David to the Babylonian exile, 14 generations. From the Babylonian exile to Christ, 14 generations. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I look forward to the genealogy every year. Long ago, I dreaded the genealogy. And when I saw it in the Bible, I said, oh, can I skip this? And Mother says, yes, you can skip the genealogies. Begat they exceedingly thusly, and then you just skip. It was said of President Eisenhower that he had read the Bible through from cover to cover many times in his youth, but his mother permitted him to skip the genealogies. And why are they here? There's another one, you know. This was Joseph's. There's another one for Mary. And it's very interesting that both of them are of royal lineage. Not just Joseph, but Mary as well. And it's essential that it be of Mary. For Joseph is a foster father, in a way. A stepfather. An adopted father. So, the kingship that flows from David has to go through Mary. We forget sometimes that it's really through the mother. As Judaism would have us to understand, that the identity as Jewish flows is through the mother, not the father. In our society, we have the primogeniture. The firstborn male seems to inherit everything, despite his lack of character. It's just his luck. And being the firstborn and having to be the gender male. But that's not how it was. It's a reminder today. And why the genealogy? Because our Lord was born in the flesh of a family, just as you and I were. And it does matter who came before. And it will matter who comes after. The important thing is those who come after us would remember us. That when they gather on sacred occasions or family reunions to celebrate a wedding or a baptism, a birth or a funeral, that they would tell our stories. They would sing our songs now that we've joined the song that never ends when we go. I enjoy all of these. As you can see, I've come to know them very well and love them. I know how to pronounce them. That's a suggestion. How far could you go with your family if you were asked to tell two generations, much less 14 times 3? Well, it doesn't matter. Well, it does matter. Oh, it does matter. Each one of them lived, and had they not lived, our Lord would not be here. Don't think any of this is random, brethren. Maybe you, like me, have some family members we would rather not claim as family members. Maybe they sang that of us too, right? But that's the way of all families and the way of the church. There are people here who are on the margins of society. There are people here who are on the margins of the temple. There are people here, who are on the margins of the church. There are many who can look in here at us, but don't feel that they can join us physically. Our Lord knows them too. And our church should know them. Many people like me do things that put ourselves outside, as we see it, the grace of God. It's not true, you know. That's just man talking again. The church is not a club, and there is no membership. We shouldn't forget that. People are often point out Tamar. Tamar was a Moabite woman. She wasn't Israelite. In fact, she was living over in a city that was to be destroyed as God's order to Joshua. Destroy it. You remember what happened when Saul went off to defeat the enemies of God and came back with booty and with the king in a cage to display the victory, his victory, though the prophet had told them, slay them all. That crazy prophet took the garment of the king and tore it from him. Sometimes God only has what he can work with, brethren, like you and me. I think about that. Oh, Lord, you surely could have done better. So, yes, yes, Julian. Yes, I could have done better, but at the time, you were the best I could work with. You too, all of you the same. All of those who are listening, you're the best that the Lord had to work with at the time. There's always someone better and someone worse, thanks be to God. I like to think so anyway. I don't want to be at the bottom of the barrel with piddle. Oh, that bad apple. But nonetheless, we were what was available. And we know, because we're here, that with God, nothing's impossible. Tamar hid Joshua's men, saved them as they reconnoitered the city prior to its defeat, and afterwards she was spared, her entire family. Another favorite to point out is Rahab. Rahab was a prostitute. I know that that may not sit well with some of the church folks, but she's in the lineage of Jesus Christ. Oh my goodness, what are we going to do now? Well, I have one like that in the family. And she was just a misbehaving lady, especially at her. As she became more mature, she seemed to be When she hit 70, I believe, she was performing in a band as the front woman, I guess they call it, the singer out front. And that was the time when Nancy Sinatra made boots famous for walking. And she was wearing plastic boots all the way up above her knees and a micro shorts. What do you call it? I can't remember the word we call it. Micro mini or something like this. And had her hair in a beehive, a bouffant, and these cap glasses. It was the most nightmarish scene on earth. And there she was performing, "These boots are made for walking." So a man was standing behind her with a big bass fiddle plucking it. You could see a pint of whiskey in his back pocket. It was a nasty situation. And I knew it was a family reunion, and my aunt said, "She's not a member of the family. It's only by marriage. It's only by marriage." Well, no excuses. No excuses. She's there. And so is she. She's there. And it's not a disqualification. It didn't derail the old human caravan into which God chose to join and turn it into the caravan of salvation. That's God's work. He enters into our life and does something with it. It may not be in our own time, but I can assure you, nothing's wasted, nothing's lost, all is gained. And before you know it, well down the road, pagans become believers, sinners become saints. You just never know how we'll get there or what God will use to get us there, even us. Come soon, Lord Jesus. Let us pray. To all who have gone before us, whose faith and life and sacrifice has built this church in which we now stand, and weigh on their shoulders, Lord. Bless them who have come before us. Bless those who will come after us. As we join the story of faith here, may our names and stories be remembered and sung. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of you gathered here this morning, for all who are hearing us, that the Lord may grant the desires of your heart, if they're worthy, according to his riches of mercy. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Please be seated. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brethren, that your sacrifice and the sacrifices of our lives may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all the church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and the offerings that we make. And since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For all of the oracles of the prophets foretold him. The Virgin Mother bore him in her womb with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist was his herald and made him known when at last he came. And so we join the song of the angels as they praise the glory of the Lord. Holy,
holy, holy,
holy,
Lord God of hosts.
Sending down your spirit upon them like the dew fall. so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
keep us safe for eternal life.
Pray for us, Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy